think she was sexy. Yeah. Get away, certainly did, huh? Was she, what, 80-something years old when she died? She looked pretty good when she got up there, too. All right, if you want to drop this line, we'd like to leave you the address. Here it is. This is how you can drop us a line. Shouldn't eat with your mouth. You shouldn't talk with your mouth full. All right, this Barry's the Catch Pajamas, WGRZ-TV, 259 Delaware Avenue in Buffalo, 14202, or the easier it would be, Barry's the Catch Pajamas, Channel 2, Delaware Avenue in Buffalo. It will probably get to us, okay? All right. Now, previews of coming attractions. Here they are. We got a little bit of comedy here. Variety Girl with Bob Hope and Charade with Audrey Hepburn. Plus Lauren Hardy up and coming Saturday night from 1 o'clock right to 6:30 in the morning. That'll do it for us. Stay tuned now to find out some very new news up and coming. And here with it is Bob Gibbs. Bob?
Thank you, Barry. Making news this morning on News Center 2, a possible drug deal gone sour leaves a Kenmore man hospitalized, and the psychic search continues. Good morning. This is News Center 2 Overnight. I'm Bob Gist. This just into the News Center. Buffalo police are on the scene at this hour investigating a shooting and a stabbing at the downtown Holiday Inn on Delaware Avenue. Details are sketchy at this hour, but one victim is believed dead. At least one other was rushed to a nearby hospital. We'll have a complete report tonight at 6. A Kenmore man remains in serious condition this morning after he was stabbed repeatedly last night. Deaconess Hospital officials say 37-year-old Thomas McWinney's condition has improved, but he's still in intensive care. Buffalo police say McWinney was attacked on Genesee Street last night in what they suspect was a drug-related incident. Officers are looking for a suspect. An Amherst man is lucky to be alive and well this Easter weekend after the car in which he was riding overturned on the Walden Avenue off-ramp of the Thrwy. 33-year-old Roger Shutt was rushed to St. Joseph's Hospital where he was treated and released. Two others in the car escaped injury. Police and volunteers in Alabama will resume their search this morning for Lockport native Beth Kenyon. Kenyon is believed to be one of the victims abducted by Christopher Wilder. Kenyon's parents are desperately trying to locate the girl. Friday, they searched dozens of cabins following the advice of a psychic who believes Kenyon is captive in a log cabin and may be guarded by a heavyset Italian man. A spring storm dumped snow out west, causing more problems for residents and holiday travelers. CNN's Bob Scott has that story and more in this report.
Wintry storms raging in the west. Hello, I'm Bob Scott. The Rocky Mountain states are reeling from a Good Friday storm that dumped more than a foot of snow in some areas. At least one person has died on ice-slick roads in Colorado, and highways throughout Colorado and Wyoming are closed. The storm system started in Utah, and the snow there is adding to the threat of heavy flooding. CNN's Ken Wu has a report.
Springtime in the Rockies and the Wasatch Mountains above Salt Lake, heavy with a record snowpack, the spring thaw can only mean trouble. The rising Salt Lake is over its banks. At a nearby resort, there is a race against time, a race to build a dike to save what little is left of Jim Silver's place.
It's pretty tough. We've invested over $2.5 million in the resort, and we've had most of our amusement rides destroyed already, and we're just trying to save the main pavilion there. And with a little bit of luck, we can do that.
Interstate 80 is a main east-west highway north of Salt Lake City. Parts are flooded, the roadway is still passable. But if the water laps any further, you'd better get out the paddle. The great threat now is mudslides. The hills above Emigration Canyon and Bountiful are heavy with water. The weekend forecast is for warming temperatures. That could be bad news if the warming is prolonged. Public works crews are getting the sandbags out just in case.
We're just about to start our major runoff period. We have two canyons that are starting to flow at the present time. We've had a little water overflowing storm sewers, and we're just getting started into the program. Well, right now, the present storm that we're having, adding new snow on the mountains and the potential to go to 80, 90 degrees within a day or two of that, is a real problem.
Hydrologists with the National Weather Service report the snowmelt prognosis for western states is not optimistic. With the continued spring runoff, the flooding situation here in the West could get worse before it gets any better. Ken Wu, CNN, Salt Lake City.
A Good Friday protest at the Pentagon. Nearly 100 anti-war nuclear activists staged the demonstration by one of the entrances yesterday. A Pentagon spokesman says five people were arrested for defacement of government property. He also says that type of demonstration has become an annual event on Good Friday. Also in Washington, the FBI is looking for a link between yesterday's bombing of a naval club and previous nighttime explosions in the Capitol. The Bureau says all the bombings have been preceded by phone calls to the news media protesting U.S. policy in Latin America. The guerrilla resistance movement is claiming responsibility for the naval yard blast. They say they're affiliated with Salvadoran rebels. Two people are being held for questioning in connection with a bomb blast at London's Heathrow Airport. Scotland Yard says the explosion is similar to others blamed on Libyan terrorists. CNN's Mike Chinoy has more on the blast.
It happened on one of the busiest days of the year in one of the busiest airports in the world. Heathrow was packed with Easter weekend travelers when the bomb went off in a customs hall. There were many injuries, most of the victims suffering only from shock or cuts caused by flying glass, but at least two reported to be in serious condition.
Well, there was just a very loud explosion and you could just hear like falling debris.
Whereabouts did the bomb go off?
Inside the customs hall, far as I could tell, anyway.
How busy was the terminal at the time?
Well, there was a lot of people outside, obviously, waiting for flights, people coming in.
And what sort of panic was there?
Very little, in fact. There was just a loud cry of everybody out, and everybody moved out of the building quite quickly.
Police immediately sealed off the entire airport, ordering the evacuation of all of Heathrow's three terminals and the diversion of most incoming flights. There were reports that a second bomb had been planted, but an urgent search turned up no such device. It's believed the explosives were placed in a suitcase, which ended up in the lost baggage area. That's where luggage, which is not claimed by arriving passengers, is stored. There's no word on where the suitcase might have come from. The terminal where the bomb went off, Terminal 2, is normally used for flights to and from Europe, but it also handles some flights to North Africa, including some to Libya. And while it's much too early to talk about a possible link with the siege of the Libyan embassy here, there's little doubt that possibility is one the police and the British government are taking very seriously. Mike Chinoy, CNN, London.
Meanwhile, the impasse at the Libyan embassy in London continues. Police are strengthening barricades around the building and sharpshooters have been called in. British and Libyan officials are meeting in Tripoli trying to end that crisis. The British are demanding the Libyans in the embassy come out and answer questions about a shooting Tuesday that left a British policewoman dead. This is CNN Headline News.
In sports, the Bisons finally got a game in yesterday. Mayor Griffin was on hand to throw out the first ball to open up the season at home. Nearly 3,000 fans braved the lousy weather as they watched the herd trample the Reading Phillies 11-3. Bisons now 1-1 for the season. Our western New York is finally beginning to cooperate just in time for the Easter weekend. The skies should be mostly sunny today with a high in the mid-50s. And for Easter Sunday, break out the new spring finery. It'll be sunny and warmer with a high near 60. Right now, it's 38. If you're wondering how you fared in Friday's New York State Lottery, the daily number 494, win 4 number 7139. That's our report for today, Saturday, April 21st. Join Mike Andre and Beverly Armstrong on News Center 2 at 6. I'm Bob Gist. Thanks for watching. Have a good day.